Hello friends, this is Alex again from Gonta, Haus German Shepherds. Before I begin, I'm posting more videos more frequently as I promised. Our channel covers dog training, dog breeding and genetics. If you like this kind of content, please consider subscribing, hitting the notification icon so you're aware when the next video comes, and I would appreciate it. Today's video will cover two topics. Dog prepotency, and it'll continue the previous video I made on line breeding, inbreeding, and outcrossing by showing specific strategies for those specific goals. In my earlier video, I talked in great detail about a lot of subjects, but I didn't concentrate on how to create a line or how to create a breed. I just touched upon it briefly. Because the nature of the subject involving genetics and biology is not easily covered in a short amount of time, I will break this video into four videos. So this is part one. In this video, we're going to cover an introduction. We're going to review the previous video. We're going to discuss natural selection versus artificial selection. We're going to talk about line breeding, inbreeding, and outcrossing again. And we're going to talk about improving the breed. In the second part of this video, we're going to cover different strategies. Strategy one will be the half sibling program. That will be video two. Video three will be the cousin program. That will be video three. And the third video will be the uncle to niece program as an inbreeding strategy. And that will be video four. So introduction is video one. Half siblings, cousins, and uncle to niece will each have their own video to describe the strategies. I'm not going to go as much into the math on this video, but you have to understand a key concept: homozygous and heterozygous genes. That is simply a must in understanding genetics. So let's begin with part one. We're going to review the previous video. In breeding animals, there are two processes involved. Actually, there are three processes involved: natural selection, and artificial selection, which is genetic pressure, but there's also training and testing and raising. So, what is natural selection? If you ever read Charles Darwin's Theory of Evolution, I think I read it in college in 1986 or 1987, I don't remember. He described being in Galapagos Islands, and the birds of that island, which were finches, adapted to worm supply and insect supply of that island, and their beak shape changed to be more efficient at catching insects of that island as opposed to the predecessor population that originated those finches. Eventually, through geographic separation and time, the finches of the Galapagos Island became their own breed, away from the finches of the mainland. The same thing could be said, for example, of the East German Shepherd versus the West German Shepherd. The Berlin Wall went up in the 1960s, early 1960s. World War II was over in 1945. So from 1945 until the fall of the Berlin Wall, I believe that was either 1989 or 1991, I don't remember. That's about 45 years of East Germany, or the DDR, the Deutsche Demokratic Republic, being a separate country from West Germany, or the GDR, the German Democratic Republic. So the German shepherds in the communist bloc did not intermarry or interbreed with the German shepherds of West Germany. So they started off as the same breed, but because of geographical separation, I mean, physically it's still one country, but because of separation of, separate East Germany from West Germany, the gene pools didn't cross with each other, and so the East German Shepherd became a separate type. I wouldn't say it became a separate breed, but it became a separate type. Had this continued further with time, it would have become a separate breed. Another example is the American Showline, or the ASL. This German Shepherd was only German 80 years ago, at the end of World War II, when our soldier boys carried German Shepherds from the front back to America. We had the movies Rin Tin Tin, which popularized the German Shepherd in that time. And so the German Shepherd breed became very popular. As the breed became very popular, people started breeding it indiscriminately for a profit, without considering what made the breed, good in the first place. An example where environmental pressure done by mankind as opposed to nature is today's Belgian Malinois, the Belgian Shepherd. There are multiple varieties, the Lacanois, the Tourvoiran, the Groenendael, and the Belgian Malinois. Most people commonly talk about the Belgian Malinois, forgetting the three other varieties. Why is the Belgian Malinois and its cousin, the Dutch Shepherd, so separately discussed from the Tourvoiran or the Groenendael or the other varieties of the Belgian Shepherd? The reason is that because in Holland there's a sport called the KNPV, the Royal Dutch Police Dog Sport, where they try to train dogs in that dog sport for police work. It's a bite sport. Now, by selecting dogs which can do this sport, they're exerting pressure on which animals get selected to breed and which ones don't. Those animals which score good points and are efficient for this sport get bred, and those animals which are more pet quality don't get bred. So the Belgian NKPV Malinois, as opposed to the Showline or Pet Malinois, is a different type within the breed. So in a sense, it's not nature making the selection. We're doing artificial selection. But the sport creates the selection process. In other words, you must performance test your dogs prior to breeding them. So if you're breeding a male and a female who are both showing the same characteristics and temperament, it is a form of selection without any inbreeding whatsoever. This will be part one. In part two, we will discuss lion breeding and inbreeding and the various strategies. Stay tuned for part two.